हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आई एग्जाम बी वंस अगेन फॉर 50% फास्टर प्रिपरेशन। आई एम चंद्र प्रकाश जोशी। ऑन संडे आई डिड अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग वर्कशॉप। रियली आई एंजॉय टॉकिंग टू यू। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम आंसरिंग फ्यू ऑफ योर क्वेश्चंस। यू मे पोस्ट मोर क्वेश्चंस, द लिंक इज गिवन बिलो फॉर द वर्कशॉप। एंड फॉर अ डायरेक्ट फेस टू फेस इंटरेक्शन यू आर मोस्ट इन्वाइटेड इन नेक्स्ट वर्कशॉप। आई वेलकम यू। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हाउ टू प्रिपेयर फॉर आरबीआई एंड सेबी टूगेदर। वेरी मच डूएबल। अबाउट 70% ऑफ द सिलेबस एंड प्रिपरेशन फॉर आरबीआई एंड सेबी इज सिमिलर। आई हैव मेड ए वीडियो, आई ऑल्सो कवर दैट इन डिटेल इन द वर्कशॉप सिंस यू हैव मिस्ड अटेंडिंग इट। द लिंक ऑफ द वीडियो, बिकॉज आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू टेक अनदर 10 minutes टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस, लिंक ऑफ द वीडियो इज गिवन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन। प्लीज गो थ्रू दैट। यू विल रियलाइज नॉट ओनली आरबीआई एंड सेबी, I covered that how RBI grade B is an umbrella exam. You can prepare for all regulatory bodies, whether it is SEBI, IRDAI, NABARD, All India Financial Institutions, ECD, CPO, NSB and many others. Please go through this. This video is going to help you. Question number 2. How do I maintain an everyday routine for the preparation of RBI grade B 2025? I would say this is very, very good question. Tough to answer, because discipline, forming habits, forming a routine is the most difficult thing. Syllabus is not difficult. Somebody will pick up in a day, somebody will take 2 days to understand the same concept, but it is most important thing to have a routine, to have a discipline. How do you build your commitment into whatever you want to do in your life? The answers are given by all knowledgeable people. You will also find a lot of content on YouTube, in all good books. You must motivate yourself. The dose of motivation you shall keep taking, but at the same time you have to build self-discipline. Choosing your friend circle, choosing your mentors, those who actually influence you positively, is very, very important in this line. What is the best thing what we learn in going to a school? Is it the knowledge? Nowadays, all kind of knowledge you can get getting subscribing to YouTube for free. You have best of the professors from Harvard or Oxford telling you various subjects. The point is, going to a school, going to a college, going to a top university brings number 9 discipline, number 2 networking. You are with the right set of people, you develop this mindset. The exclusive course, in which you get access to talk to the faculty member, access to talk to others, is one good way to build a discipline. But there are other 5 ways. It depends on what you can do right away and how much committed you are. If you are committed, you will definitely find out routine, and if you build a routine, your commitment will increase. So this flywheel, you have to give some push, and then more push will come when you are with right set of people, and then you have to give more push to yourself, and this fly will then will fly. Another question: I cleared RBI grade B prelims in 2022 and 23, but this year 24 I could not clear. Shall I stop preparation? Just to answer, because the right answer, you only knows how much risk you are taking, what is your financial situation, what is your age. There are many angles to it, but you have already cleared prelims 2 times. It means you have a good level of preparation, but there is no guarantee. You have already seen this time you could not clear the prelims, so there is no guarantee that there will be a final selection. Now you shall continuously prepare for phase 1 and phase 2 together, because this time if you again clear phase 1 in 2025, you shall not miss a chance to clear the complete exam. So you shall prepare for both, and you understand now phase 1 how difficult or how. I am very confident with this failure you are better today. You are much better today, but the point is phase 2 preparation, the thing for your final selection. So you must start that preparation simultaneously and also appear in all other related exams. Next question is how to start RBI grade B preparation. Many people have written this and many people ask. I have made a video about this. I am pursuing MBA in marketing and finance from NIBM. NIBM is a RBI owned institution. So my dream is to work with RBI, and I'm in final year. What shall I do? So boss, even if you are doing MBA from any top institute, whether it is even IIMs, you have to still clear RBI grade B exam. So for you, there will be certain advantage in the phase 2. You first prepare for phase 1 so that you get to phase 2, and then simultaneously prepare for phase 2. Crack the exam. That is the only way to get into RBI. Wish you all the best. I'm a third year student in Delhi University, third year BCom student, and I am from NEP. Is it mandatory for me to complete 4 years if I want to write RBI grade B exam? No. Fourth year is optional. You do your graduation in 3 years and you have 60% marks, you are eligible for RBI Grade B. One girl has written, I desperately want RBI Grade B. I always recommend to put all your sincere effort, you will get it. You will get it. It may take time here and there, but if you are really putting right effort in the right direction, nothing is so difficult. RBI Grade B is simply an exam. Monitor your progress step by step. I am a married person. How to prepare? It doesn't make a difference. You are a married person or a working professional. Ultimately, you have to clear the exam. So strategy remains the same. You have to find out the time for your preparation. Final year students are eligible or not? No, it is very clear. Final year students are not eligible, but next year also you can expect the notification may not come very early. So prepare well. By the time you will complete your degree. अगला प्रश्न है हिंदी मीडियम में प्रिपरेशन कैसे करें? हिंदी मीडियम में प्रिपरेशन बिल्कुल कर सकते हैं. इंटरव्यू हिंदी में दे सकते हैं. सारा एग्जाम हिंदी में आप लिख सकते हैं. एक्सेप्ट द इंग्लिश पेपर. तो आप हिंदी मीडियम में तैयारी करते हो, ये ध्यान रखिएगा कि आपको इंग्लिश का पेपर इंग्लिश में ही लिखना है. फेज वन में भी ऑब्जेक्टिव इंग्लिश है और फेज टू में डिस्क्रिप्टिव इंग्लिश है. इतनी इंग्लिश आना जरूरी है. हमारे पास एग्जाम में हिंदी मीडियम के स्टूडेंट्स के लिए सारा कंटेंट हिंदी में है. आप चेक कर सकते हैं, डेमो पे जा सकते हैं. आई एम एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी. हाउ शुड आई प्रिपेयर? मेरा तो पहला क्वेश्चन आपसे होगा, शैल यू प्रिपेयर? आप असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर हो. If you are already enjoying your job, you may be a good academic person, you may be good, more interested in writing books or teaching. RBI Grade B salary is better, but for 3000 rupees, you shall go for RBI Grade B. I don't know. It depends on your choices because RBI Grade B is a generalist job. If you have done Masters in Economics, you may try for DEPR. Statistics, you can try DSIM because that job is more related to the work you are doing now. That is completely research. But in general side, you have to do many things. If you have interest in that, you may apply. Otherwise, you may continue with your current profession. It is a great profession because you are already an assistant professor. It will help you in writing your answers descriptive part. One person is writing, my age is 30 years. What options I have? If you are from unreserved category, you do not have any option unless you are working in a bank. There is a similar question. I am 31 year old and I exhausted my age limit for RBI Grade B. Working in RRB, have 47 months of experience. So here, that is the way, because you have 47 months of experience, you have crossed 30, up to 3 years of the work experience, you get 3 years of the age relaxation. Means maximum up to 33 years of the age, you can appear in RBI Grade B exam. So you please continue to prepare if you are working in RRB or any other bank or financial institution. This is clearly mentioned in the notification. So up to 33 years, you can appear. If you have that many months working experience in these financial institutions and scheduled commercial bank. Next question is, from where to cover general awareness? Answer is very simple. Your one bible for general awareness is BPDA. In BPDA, you will not only get all the current affairs topic wise, but also the learn along section, which will tell you the static knowledge related to that topic, which is very, very important, because if you see the question of the general awareness, there are more number of questions from the static knowledge. Second thing, which I recommend for 2025 aspirant, because you have time in your hand, reading newspaper. Reading newspaper will not only help you in general awareness, but also in your descriptive exam, you will develop your writing skill. You must read a financial newspaper, a business newspaper. Example is like Business Standard, Mint, Economics Times. Another question is, how is life at the rate of RBI? So we all know life at the RBI is very fantastic. I have made several videos on that. And if you want to know more about the job, 101 stories, which are available on the channel. Next question is, how to excel in the descriptive part? A very appropriate question, because descriptive is your 2/3 of the exam. You read good in-depth topics, say newspaper editorials, articles written in RBI bulletin, speeches of RBI governors, because these are relevant to the topic also. No, you may be reading a very, very good fictional book which has got maybe Booker's Prize or Pulitzer Prize. That is fine. It will definitely help you building your English. But the relevance of the subject will come if you are reading something related to economics, finance, banking, development, corporate issues, economic and social issues, poverty, development, agriculture, etc. So read these kind of material. More important is you practice writing. So reading will frame your mind for that. But unless you know how to express a powerful sentence in few words, you have to describe something which is hitting to the mind of the reader. So this art you have to develop and you have to practice. But we have made several videos on descriptive writing. especially the video made by Dr. Sharma, who is also faculty in IIM Ahmedabad, ISB, IIM Lucknow, a former Chief General Manager of RBI. Please go through some of his videos which are available here and you will understand the beauty of every word, how you have to place that word in a sentence, and that is how you become better and better in writing descriptive answers, which are a good mix of your knowledge and your power of expression. Another very interesting question: I completed 80% of the syllabus, but when I am going to the questions, I am finding I have forgotten everything. How to revise? Completing syllabus is nothing. You have done 100% syllabus, but if you have not retained it, if you are not able to answer the question, how would it help? That is why I always say these short videos. So in Examby, we have short videos in the course, 10 minutes. Because one time watching the video is not enough. One time live class is not enough. You have to understand the concept multiple times. If I tell you I do a class, say 1 hour class on the financial statement, balance sheet, income statement and cash flow statement, do you think you will pick up everything? Many of you are hearing first time these are the three things in the financial statement and what is the difference. So you have to absorb these terms because the questions are based on the concept. Study it again and again, revise through the notes and do lot of questions, lot of discussion, then only you will learn the topic. Otherwise, feeling happy that I have done 80% of the syllabus is of no meaning. Revision through these short videos, revision through the questions, chapter-wise questions is the key here, my friend. Please do that. The more you revise, the more question you do from every chapter, the better you become, your score will improve. Next question: how do I prepare doing self-study? Tell me the book and toolkit. Self-study, first I must take a minute to talk about it. Every one of you have to do self-study. It does not matter you have taken a course from iExamby or from anywhere. You go to the top of the universities, you have to do a lot of self-study. And you will be surprised to know in top of the university, the number of classes given by the professors actually decreases because they give you a lot of assignment to do. Lot of work you have to do, some individual studies, some in group studies. Self-study is must. Every one of you have to do self-study. Study can be done only self. From the inside, you have to open the door. So nobody can push knowledge inside you unless you are not pulling it. About the books and the toolkits, some of the books are mentioned in the notification, but you can't read all these books, only go through the selective chapter. For the phase 1, books are not mentioned in the notification, but these are very common books for quant, reasoning, English, books like R.S. Agarwal, M.K. Pandey, and for general awareness, BPDI is freely available to you. Newspaper, you must study. You start with this and then you do previous year papers, see where are you lacking. You will find out rest yourself. The next question is, which online course I shall take? I am a little confused. So the best way to make a decision is go to the demo. Every online platform provides you access to a demo course. Go to the demo, attend some free workshop and see what you are able to understand. See the structure of the course, whether it is meeting your requirement. Some people want long lectures of 1.5 hours. Some people say, no, I can't do that individually online. How do I watch 1.5 hour recorded session? I come from some background. I already know economics or I have done MBA, so I know finance. I rather want to focus more on this subject, so I need this topic first. How can I personalize my study? Everybody has a very unique need. Go to this free demo course, everywhere these are available. Then see what are your gaps, what do you want from a course. List down maybe 5-6 things which are most important for you. Talk to a few people. If you can get access to somebody who has cleared the exam, that will be very helpful. If you are not able to reach out to these people who have cleared the exam, they have a lot of testimonials in all YouTube videos and written content. Then make a final decision. It is very important to decide a right course for you, because it is not just a matter of few thousand rupees here and there. The matter is your time. You are going to invest maybe year, 1 year, 2 year in preparation of these exam, and your career is at stake. Therefore, you shall go to the best course available so that you bring best out of you. I have still a lot of questions to answer, but I am stopping it here today. Otherwise, this video is becoming very long. I will answer remaining questions in the next video. If you don't know about this big B day, this is once in a year. You have the opportunity, go to the best course, exclusive course, where you are meeting the faculty members, all your doubts are getting cleared, and most importantly, you are getting the right mindset for getting success in life, for bringing the best out of you. I wish you all the best. You are finding these questions helpful. Please share in your friend circle. Subscribe to the channel. We are here to make job preparation 50% faster.